thank a number of people, obviously all of the staff here at the Soldiers Memorial Hall, and in particular Ian Charlton for putting the car up on stage. Thanks, Ian. And we need to thank Dave Pearson and Kathy Wilkins, for providing the keyboard tonight, because our keyboard wouldn't fit on the Rex plane. So there was all sorts of phone calls and stuff that went on. We particularly want to thank Mick and who was the other fella driving the car?
James, who's Mick's son. Yeah. And we came up from Lincoln in a 55 Chev, and we were met at the airport. Like, how cool is this? You guys, you know, I mean, you're all car club people, or a lot of you are. So a 55 Chev picked us up. And also, I went in James's 1959 Bel Air, or both Bel Airs, and fair dinkum, you reckon the 59 Bel Air didn't get up and go? It was like a... was really cool.
So what that meant was the minute that we landed in Port Lincoln and began to drive over to Tubby Bay, we felt like we were on the prowl!
Oh,
and the drums, cymbals, vocals, and cowbell. Where's that cowbell, Freddie? I haven't got a cowbell. Right. Paul Gatsby on drums and vocals, of course. My longtime colleague, my partner in crime, one of the greatest frontmen in Australian history, the electric one, Mr. Dynamite, Frankie T. Holland.